Good day. This is John Reinecker, Technical Services Manager at Kermetico, discussing with you the ID capability that we've developed over the years. We have both an HVAF and HVOF ID coding capability with the equipment we've designed and built. With this equipment, we can apply corrosion and wear-resistant coatings on internal surfaces of things such as pipes and fittings, bends, pump housings, volutes, cylinder bores, and complex parts like Francis runners for hydro turbines. And we can apply tungsten carbide coatings and metal alloy coatings as well. Here we have a chart that displays all of the ID guns we have. An AKID, a convertible ID, an AKIDR, which rotates, a convertible IDR, which runs in HVAF and HVOF mode and is a rotating gun. We have an AK5 ID and an AK5 ID rotating version as well. You can read the chart and see that there's quite a range of coding capabilities with these tools, and we're able to spray tungsten carbide, cobalt chrome, Hastelloy type alloys, as well as metal alloys and general carbides like chrome carbide, for example. And the system that we use to run this equipment, the C system, is also capable of running every gun in our product line. So we have the maximum versatility. The convertible HVAF and HVOF guns are used on internal diameters where the smallest is 3.15 inches or 80 millimeters, and we can get into 5 foot deep bores with our fixed ID gun. Spray angle is 90 degrees for maximum deposit efficiency and coating quality. We have axial powder feed and air cooling. And we use two different sizes of powder. In the smaller IDs, we use the finer particle size to get the best velocity. And in the larger diameters, we use the slightly larger powder size to improve coating quality. And you can see that difference as it results in the hardness in this area here. We're showing you the various hardnesses compared to the various IDs that we might spray. These things all matter, obviously. We're using our IDR rotating gun to spray bores 4 inches and larger, and we can get up to 600 millimeters deep, or about 2 feet. We need the extra room for the gun to spin around to maintain a proper spray distance. Spray rate on all our ID guns, the smaller ones, is 11 pounds an hour, with, as I said, a 90 degree spray angle, two powder sizes, and that's best at spraying tungsten carbide, cobalt chrome, and Hastelloy type materials. The AK5 ID is a very versatile gun. We can spray up to 33 pounds an hour, about 15 kilograms, and the heat output is reduced significantly over our larger guns, so we use this on thin walls, internal surfaces, small parts, and other low mass type parts where temperature control becomes problematic for anything much larger than this. We can get into 8 inches and larger with this gun and spray a respectable coating. And we're using two different particle sizes. Again, it varies with the size of the spray distance we're working with. The finer powders accelerate faster and shorter distances, but the larger particle sizes result in a better coating. We can arrange this gun to have a spray angle of 90 or 45 degrees, depending on the application that may be useful. And we're spraying 86-10-4, chrome carbide, nickel chrome, Hastelloy type material, super stainless, onto sleeves, flanges, valves, shafts, spindles, rods, shafts. Again, we spray a lot of shafts and tubes. And we have also a rotating version of this gun and specialized versions available with special request. Here we have the same gun, the AK5 ID gun, in a rotating version, spraying a rather large refinery vessel. The coating here is Hastelloy C-type material to resist acid attack. These pressure vessels have to be made out of mild steel, because they are pressure vessels, but they are also not very corrosion resistant, and a refinery comes up with all sort of acid-based substances that the vessels are being deteriorated by, and by adding just 10 thousandths of Hastelloy C-type materials in an unsealed coating, resist that acid attack supremely well, and it extends the life of the vessel significantly. Obviously, the refinery is very happy with this approach. We also spray a lot of heat exchanger shells. Same coating, same problem. And in the picture on the lower right-hand side, you get a real good idea about the size of this vessel compared to our 5,000-pound capacity fork truck. These guys are big, they're heavy, and our little AK-5 does a beautiful job of applying the coating. And up in the upper right, you see what the finished coating looks like. I might say that's a very pretty coating. We also use our rotating gun to spray parts that don't rotate very well. And the best example of that is this double elbow, where we have two 45-degree bends in different planes. Talk about a nightmare. The overall length of this part was almost 6 feet, if you run it over the curves, and point-to-point's about 5 feet long from end to end in a straight line distance. Clearly, this was a tricky job, but with our rotating ID gun, the AK-5, we were able to apply a very nice tungsten carbide cobalt chrome coating everywhere and put this in service for either coke or a refinery catalyst. I'm not sure which one this was used for. We do a lot of them. This was a cyclone that we also coated. This is a coke cyclone, and we used our rotating technology to coat the transitions, the cyclone itself, you know, the every square inch of the interior of this thing got coated. Here you see the body of the cyclone being coated. I'm going to back up one. This is the nozzle. Notice that it goes from round to rectangular. Here you see the rectangular entrance of that transition. Here's the external on the transition. We actually use two of our ID guns. We use the rotating gun on, we use the rotating gun on the circular part, and on the rectangular part, we used our ID fixed gun, the AK-4. And here we are coating the body, and in the upper right here, you see what the coating looked like when it was finished. We also use the same technology, rotating ID gun, spraying 6-inch elbows. We do them from both ends, and with some tricky angles and manipulation by the robot, we can actually cover the entire interior, even in the bend. The major and minor radiuses are both coated. Here we have, again, another use for the ID gun, the fixed ID gun, the AK-4 or AKID. And here we're spraying a 3.5-inch ID on the left and a 4-inch ID on the right. We also have a number of outer diameter guns, or normal thermal spray guns, HVAF, and convertible OF guns that will run on the same system. So the system that you're using to control your ID gun, whether it's an AF or an OF, and your outer diameter guns for major spraying, all run on the same system. It's all air-cooled. You operate it from a portable teach pendant, tablet-like device. The system's guts are run and controlled by a PLC system that's very durable, a robust industrial system. And we have now more than 60 of them working in the field all around the world. We've got a lot of experience in coatings. I myself have been in thermal spray since 1980. Andrew, our director, has been in coatings about the same amount of time. And we've been building equipment here in Benicia, California since 2006. We have 20-some-odd systems in universities and national labs. We have a number of academic papers published showing the superiority of HVAF coatings over HVOF coatings. And these can be viewed on our website at Kermetico.com under on our publications page, which is found under the heading About Us on the main page, on the home page. Anyone is welcome to visit our job shop to see us operating on a daily basis with our equipment that we design and build here. Everything we built and designed arises from a real-world application that we've done in our job shop. We also have distributors around the world, China, Europe, Italy and Poland. We have India has representation, Japan, Russia has representation in Placart, and in Southeast Asia we have Bexon Global. And we're missing one. We have a representative in New Jersey Plasma Powders. You're welcome to send in your questions or call. Contact information is on our website at kermetico.com. My email is at the bottom of every page of this presentation. Do not hesitate if you have a question. We'll be happy to address those questions with answers. Have a very good day, and thanks for listening.